In these ayahuasca states, what you see are group-generated acoustical hallucinations. Part of the transformation that I think is going to happen to us lies in the way we deal with language neurologically. Because under the influence of psychedelics, especially short-acting tryptamines like DMT, you experience phenomena which seem to be transformations of the language modality. And I've described this stuff as visible language. Visible language, that you can actually sing meaning into visible existence. And I've seen this on ayahuasca. This is what ayahuasca is about, the famous group states of mind that anthropologists talk about. What they really are the three-dimensional acoustical sculptures that are made by groups of people who are lonely. And it's an extraordinary thing. It's an experience you can't have any other way, and it's just not quite telepathy, or perhaps more than telepathy. And I think the key concept in communications is bandwidth. Bandwidth. The more bandwidth you have, the more detail, color, tone you can impart to your signal. Well, a very low bandwidth channel is the small mountain channel. And this is about as primitive as it gets. I mean, short of doing it in Morse code. In these ayahuasca, what you see are group-generated acoustical hallucinations. And because ayahuasca is composed of psychedelic compounds which occur in normal brain chemistry, in other words, nothing exotic to human brain tissue is present, it raises the question, well, how close is normal metabolic chemistry to be having the ability to do this? And the answer is, nobody knows, but very, very close. We'll be right back. such an odd phenomenon in the American art scene. I mean, notice the detecting of which raises a real question about how you get that coordinated the first time out. What you see are group-generated acoustical hallucinations.